So, the XFL announced several multi-year TV deals for when they kick things off next year in 2020. They're gonna have weekly games on regular TV with ABC and Fox, same way the AAF kinda had with CBS. But then they'll take it a step further and also have weekly games on cable juggernauts ESPN, ESPN2, FS1, FS2, or you know, all the Fox networks. So every week over the course of a 10-week season, they're gonna have Saturday doubleheaders and then Sunday doubleheaders. Now, as you can see, that's with the exception of week 9 and 10, where they're gonna have Thursday night primetime games. I think it's dope how they got this because it means that everybody's gonna have easy access to the games regardless to your home television situation, you know? A lot of people don't have cable, a lot of people only have cable, but this is gonna help get the games in front of a lot more people. And when you think about how much ground they're covering with these channels, they're really gonna hit a lot of demographics, man. When you think about this from like an advertising standpoint, they're covering a ton of ground. Now, the season's gonna start next year only 6 days after the Super Bowl. So after the NFL season ends, we're not gonna have to wait long to get some more pro football. Literally the next week, we got a new league that'll be starting up, so that's what's up. And now that Tom Dundon happened to the AAF, there's gonna be no competition for the XFL. Hopefully, they got this thing carefully mapped out and carefully planned out. After the epic fail that they had the last time, for all of these networks to be on board, I gotta think that they gotta be pretty well buttoned up. But of course, we're gonna have to see how it plays out. I actually think the failure that the XFL already has gives them a huge benefit. I've never failed at something and not gotten better at it. And the bigger the failure, the more I learn. So I'm pretty sure that's gonna be the case with this league. They also have the benefit of seeing the AAF fail, giving them even more context and even more experience that they didn't even have to go through themselves. They can just look at what that league did wrong, which was mainly coming in without having enough money to start. But I think the AAF wanted to kind of get out there before the XFL started up and try to snatch up that fan base that took the gamble. You know, we all know how it played out. The XFL has money and now they've got the reach to get their product in front of as many people as possible. They also have the benefit of just having a bigger brand to start with. Now, the variable is gonna be how good the on-field play is gonna be. Like, what is the football talking about? Like, that's gonna be the variable, that and the players that they can get to come in. And it's funny because when we first started talking about these two leagues, I don't know, might have been a couple years ago now, it's been a while. I remember reading the comments and I felt the same exact way. Like people's overwhelming assumption was that the AAF was gonna be the league that was more buttoned up, more professional, and the one that would succeed. And we felt like the XFL, based on what happened last time, was gonna come in and not really be ready. They seemed to rush everything, but they took the extra year. They seem like they got everything in place. The AAF has already flamed out and created just a huge opportunity for them to come in and knock it out of the park, man. So we're gonna have to see how it goes. But what do y'all think? Let me know in the comment sections. Will the XFL succeed or will it go the way of the AAF and pretty much end spring football leagues for good? My name is Flimlo Raps. I'm out at you next time. 1.